This is Eric, the Cocos Evangelist. Today's video and the following ones will be based on the minigame Mind Your Step and will be a segmented video tutorial. All content will be centered around this minigame. If you want to develop with Cocos Creator, first you need to download it. Go to our official website, select Products, Cocos Creator, pull to the bottom of the page and click on Download. Then you can see all the current version numbers of Cocos Creator. So which one should we choose? You should choose version 3.0.1 instead of 2.4.5 because we will soon stop updating the features of version 2.x. Only bugs and major issues will be fixed. And version 3.x is now the mainline version, so you should choose version 3.0.1. There are two buttons below. If you've never downloaded any version of Cocos Creator, please download the dashboard, which is a multi-version management tool. After downloading, double-click on the installation package. Since I'm using macOS, just drag the icon into Applications. If you're using Windows, just follow the steps to install. Double-click on the dashboard. The login screen will open by default the first time. If you already have a Cocos account, just enter your username and password here. If you don't, click Sign Up to jump to the registration page. You can register here. Once you've logged in, you'll see a panel like this. The top of the panel shows the current version number of the dashboard. On the left are a column of tabs. The first tab is Project, which shows all currently open projects. If this is your first time using the dashboard, the list should be empty. Since I've opened some projects before, they are all listed here. The project list contains information about each project, including project name, path, the version number of the editor most recently used to open the project, and the number of days since the last modification. On the right is a menu, which allows you to open the folder where the current project is located. Remove the project from the list, and select the icon of the project, etc. The next tab is Editor. All downloaded editor versions are listed here. If it's your first time using the dashboard, the list is empty as well. Click Download to jump to the download page. Select the version you want to download. You can download multiple versions like me. As you can see, I've downloaded three different versions, Creator 3.0.0, 3.0.1, and 2.4.5. Sometimes we release beta versions on our forum. You can click Locate to associate the versions downloaded externally with the dashboard. Once associated, they can be managed in the dashboard. All Creator versions managed by dashboard can be selected here when opening the project. If a project is developed with version 2.x, it can be opened by version 3.x, and vice versa. If a project is developed with higher versions of 3.x, it is not recommended to open it with lower versions of 3.x. If your project is developed with 3.0.1, you better not open it with 3.0.0 because there will be an asset upgrade check during the opening of the project. If the project is found to be downgraded, there is a possibility of data disorder. The next tab is Community. In News, you can receive some latest news about Cocos. And in Update, you can find update notes of different creator versions. The last tab is Learn. You can learn how to use Cocos Creator via tutorials and demos. Let's take a look at the two buttons here in the Project tab. The first one is Add Project. The second one is New Project. Add Project allows you to add currently existing projects. You can manage them in the list. Since I'm going to teach you how to make a game like Mind Your Step, we need to create a new project. Okay, next, let me create a new project. Listed here are all the editor versions you currently have downloaded. I'll use the latest 3.0.1. There are three types of projects: Empty Project, Hello World, and Example Taxi Game. To make the game look better, I've prepared my own resources. So here I choose Empty Project. Name it Mind Your Step. create and open. Next, let's take a look at the basic game development process in Cocos Creator. The first step is to create a game world, which corresponds to one of the creator's basic elements, the scene. It's located at the top of the node list in the hierarchy panel. The scene consists of multiple nodes. They are organized in a tree-like structure, so we call it the node tree. The node is the smallest unit of the game world. A person or tree is made up of nodes. Usually, what properties does a default node have? We can see the properties of the selected node in the inspector panel. The default node has properties like position, rotation, and scale. If you want the node to have more properties, you can add components to it. When a scene is created, it will have two nodes by default. One is the main light node. Another is the main camera. The main light is similar to the sunlight in real life. When we select any of the two nodes in the inspector panel, we can see their special components. The properties in their components can be edited directly in the editor. All changes to these properties are displayed simultaneously in the scene panel. Since the game world is not created yet, we can't see a significant effect. Once the game scene is built, the effect will be obvious. You can also edit the nodes directly in the scene panel. In the process of game development, we usually need some nice art resources to make our game world more beautiful. We can drag the game assets into the assets panel to manage and use them. We can also add animations to a node to give it some animation effects. All prompts during use are output via the console panel, which include locks and warnings during use, etc. In the next video, I'll walk you through the basic process of game development in Creator through specific operations. That's all for today. Thank you.